Blackstone Publishing presents A Long Time Ago in a Cutting Room Far, Far Away. My 50 years editing Hollywood hits, Star Wars, Carrie, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, Mission Impossible, and more, by Paul Hirsch. This book is read by Richard Ferrone. Introduction. In 1975, I edited a film directed by Brian De Palma called Obsession. It was an independent production, and upon its completion, no studio in Hollywood would agree to release it because of an edgy plot development. After some thought, I suggested changing one shot in the film from a wide establishing shot of a mansion to a close-up of our star. With this one substitution, Columbia Pictures agreed to distribute the film. That is what editing can do. I've been working in the film business for 50 years. I have participated in big successes and big failures. At one point, I had worked on both the biggest hit of all time and the biggest flop, but I'd have to say, all in all, I have led a charmed life. This book is intended to share with you my experiences in the business, as well as some of my opinions and the insights I gleaned from the many extraordinary figures I have met and worked with. Think of the world's biggest movie stars, the most powerful producers, the most talented writers, directors, and cinematographers hired by one of Hollywood's historic studios to create a movie into which they will pour hundreds of millions of dollars to market and distribute around the world. Sometimes over 1,000 people are employed on a single movie. The production crew spends weeks and months carefully prepping the shoot, building sets, designing costumes, and scouting locations. Then they spend more weeks and months shooting, often in bitter cold or broiling heat, in the rain or snow, at night, hours on end, with too little sleep, eating in tents, often 12 or more hours a day. Actors will show up hours before shooting just to be properly made up or coiffed. All this investment of time, money, creativity, and physical effort combines to provide the editor with his or her raw materials. That's me, the editor. It's the best job on a movie. Editing is a bit of a misnomer. Just as the pocket computers we all carry are called phones, even though making phone calls is just a fraction of what we use them for, editing film is just one facet of the job. We editors spend a great deal of time building up the first cut. It's as if we're given a big box containing all the parts needed to put together a gizmo of some kind, except there is a lot of other junk in the box as well. We sift through all the footage shot each day, looking for and extracting the useful parts of each angle or setup. We then cut these together into longer and longer sequences or scenes. Sometimes these useful parts are analogous to sentences. Other times, they're like phrases or individual words or even syllables strung together to form meanings greater than their constituent parts. The shots derive their meaning from their context. Context is everything. You can take the most affecting moment of a four-hanky movie and cut it into the middle of a broad comedy, and it will seem absurd. We must choose with care how to frame the best moments. Looking through dailies, the raw footage shot on a particular day, is hunting for jewels, and once they're found, we have to mount them to maximum effect. What precedes a shot is critical, and the art of editing is, in part, how to make each shot achieve its full potential in the sequence. Building the first cut is not just cutting out the bad stuff, but, more important, putting together a collage out of bits of action and sound. Which bits the editor chooses and how they're arranged makes his or her work unique. Not until all the scenes have been shot and each one has been built into a rough version of itself can the editing phase of post-production really begin. This process, cutting the final version that the audience will see, is the most interesting and crucial step in the editing.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.